Coming up tonight, Prime Minister inspects evacuation centres, power rationing to continue, and Fiji establishes new diplomatic ties. Good evening, I'm Sandra Assam. The Prime Minister Vorenge Bainimarama is currently on a tour of the flood-affected areas in the Western Division and has been informed firsthand by the divisional administrators and department heads of the mammoth task they face in getting aid across to those affected. Fiji News is currently on tour with the Prime Minister and filed this report.
Nandrunga and Navosa are one of the areas badly hit by the continuous rain which started last Friday, and some areas remain cut off and aid cannot get across. This was the message relayed to the Prime Minister Vorenge Bainimarama as he started his tour of the affected areas in Nandrunga and Navosa. The National Disaster Management Office of Nandrunga and Navosa informed the Prime Minister that while aid has reached the Western Division, the upper Nandrunga area is cut off as roads are not accessible, while communication is cut off as well. However, military personnel are now working to clear out the debris and fix infrastructure to have the food rations, water purification tablets, and 1 week supply of food taken across. The Prime Minister was also informed that Lawanga Creek and Singatoka River overflowed, and this has seen over 3,000 people evacuated. According to the DSMEC office in Nandrunga, Semo and Dhuvu villages have been the worst hit, and authorities are waiting for flood waters to recede before the damage can be assessed. PWD workers and military personnel are working on clearing the silt and debris on road and various dams and even the boreholes so that water supply can be normalised. While work is being done to clear the major roads so that accessibility is possible, people have been heeding the advice from government and going to the nearest DSMEC office to seek assistance. The Prime Minister also visited various evacuation centres, first visiting the Singatoka Methodist Primary School. And senior, the Prime Minister has a discussion with the family that had to flee the rising waters early in the morning. Bainimarama was also informed by a resident at the evacuation centre that they had to flee the rising waters and they only have the clothes on their back. The Prime Minister also visited Matavo pumping station and saw works being done to get the essential service up and running. He also took time out to have a joke with some of those in evacuation centres at Noko Noko District School, and he also learned that his entourage was the first vehicles to pass through the area following the flood over the weekend. The Prime Minister expressed concern that there were plenty of small children at the centres.
We must get the aid. That's why I asked this morning whether you have babies, eh?
Sure.
No.
Infants.
Sure. Infants. Because they're different class of people. They can eat ndalo and tabok. They have to have special food, eh?
Meanwhile, as floodwaters receded in some areas, people started to pick themselves up and shop owners started cleaning up as well. Nandi Town was a wreck as waters receded and the city council was quick to start clearing up debris. And the people of Nandi took advantage of what little sunshine there was to start cleaning up. Meanwhile, the Prime Minister and the Permanent Secretary of Information, Sharon Smith-Johns, also met up with a new family or a young couple from the Naita Siri area whose daughter arrived the night of the flood.
Tropical Cyclone Daphne might not be a direct threat to the Fiji group, but people are still being reminded to please take precautionary measures and move to higher grounds as heavy downpour will continue. Laisia Sakumbu with this report.
Tropical Cyclone Daphne was located to the far south of Fiji this afternoon and no longer poses a direct threat to the country. It was moving towards the southeast at about 30 to 35 kilometers per hour and as such is expected to move away from Fiji today. However, while it is moving away, the cyclone center will remain at least 500 kilometers to the southwest of Nandi, and the country could experience further heavy rain and flooding. Damaging gale force winds are expected for the southwestern half of the country. Close to the center, the cyclone is estimated to have average wind speeds of 65 km per hour. Periods of rain are expected to be heavy at times and squally thunderstorms, which will see low-lying areas expected to be flooded. The water level of the Rewa River has dropped to 2.97 meters this morning, less than the critical level. By this afternoon, the water level was expected to drop more if there is no rain. Despite the drop in water level, Commissioner Central Division Lise near Tuitumbo continues to advise people living along the Rewa River to always take heed of advice and take necessary actions. During the aerial survey yesterday, authorities and our Fiji News team caught sight of ignorant people swimming in flooded area. Right now, 7 lives have been lost due to carelessness and taking authorities' advice lightly. Again, people are advised to keep away from flood-affected areas, move to higher grounds or to the nearest evacuation centres. For those wishing to travel through the King's Road, the Wailuatua Flats and Bridge is now open to all traffic, but motorists are advised to take extra precaution while driving along the area. Despite the road being open, naval officers who were dispatched to the area will continue to assess and monitor the situation until the situation normalizes.
Government agencies are currently assessing the extent of damages caused by the torrential heavy rain brought by Tropical Cyclone Daphne.
As Tropical Cyclone Daphne moves away from the Fiji group, more rain and strong winds is expected to affect the country. DSMAC is urging members of the public to heed the safety advice given in light of the loss of 7 lives. Since yesterday, key government agencies and departments responsible have been on the ground monitoring the situation. An aerial survey was also conducted by DSMAC to see the extent of damage to both the central and western divisions. Seen here is the evidence of the overflow of the Vaturu Dam in the western division caused by the heavy rain. The impact to surrounding areas from the torrential flow of water has created landslides and damaged infrastructure. The new motor bridge in Bar is now visible from being submerged by raging floodwaters. Rarawai Sugar Mill in Bar was also affected by the strong currents, while businesses along Bar Town and in the Western Division struggled to come to terms with the situation and begin the cleanup of debris brought by the floods. The situation was the same for settlements along Bar to Lautoka. Seen here is the village of Matawalu, with villagers coming to terms with the damage caused. Indiscriminate logging in the highlands is also a major contributor to the fast runoff that has also damaged sugarcane farms, as seen here in Nandi. Even resort boats and cruise ships had berthed at a sheltered spot away from the strong winds to prevent damage to resort property. Developments along Naisoso and Denarau have also felt the brunt of nature with heavy rains brought by Tropical Cyclone Daphne. The adverse weather has also disrupted water supplies. Seen here is a government budge delivering water to hotels along the Coral Coast. While water has begun to recede in Nandi, there are still some areas that are underwater, such as the Nandi bus stop and parts of Nandi town. The situation in Singatoka was worse, with floodwaters affecting farms, homes and villages in the area. DSMAC is once again urging members of the public to stay on high ground and not attempt to cross flooded creeks, rivers and streams.
Coming up after the break, power sharing to continue in Central Division and evacuees safety paramount.